send a letter to a sissy like you.
And you've always got something to say. Well, I've got something to say. And I think all the people here will agree with me. I think the PS stands for Prissy Sissy.
PSAs. We'll be describing the action, ladies and gentlemen. And we just, before we talk about the hour, some, I think the fans, I said this one time before, that PS can stand for a lot of things. Obviously, you have your definition of what PS stands for in your own mind.
Everybody else does too. They're just afraid to admit it.
The fans here is pretty unanimous. Prissy Sissy seems to be prevalent throughout.
No. Everybody knows it's purely sexy. That broad is crazy about me. She just can't admit it. And DiBiase, you're starting something, boy, that you're going to be sorry about. You just mark my words. But there's a lot coming up. We got two title matches,
two championship matches, ladies and gentlemen. Terry Taylor will defend the television title against a newcomer named called the Libyan. We'll also see Steve Dr. Death Williams get the biggest opportunity in his career.
Ever,
as he goes against Bam Bam, Terry Bam Bam Gordy for the UWF Heavyweight Championship. You're going to see Cowboy Bill Watts against Korchenko with some very special stipulations.
If he wins, he gets Eddie Gilbert.
Yes, sir.
5 minutes, and I'll tell you what, you won't see that on any other wrestling program in the world.
And you will see the missing link against Jack Victory. That and so much more in this hour. It's going to be one of the most power-packed lineups we've ever been able to bring you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for being with us. We'll be keeping you updated on a lot of big events in the Universal Wrestling Federation area. So right now, I think we're ready. Let's go to the ring in our first match.
I'm sexy.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match for the UWF television title, the challenger from Libya at 270 pounds, the Libyan. Introducing the current UWF television champion from Vero Beach, Florida, 235 pounds, Terry Taylor! This match, one fall or 10-minute time limit.
You know, Jim Ross, I really don't feel Terry Taylor deserves that belt. You know, and I know that Buddy had him beat just a couple weeks here ago on UWF television, and I think it's hypocrisy, and it's a blatant ripoff. That Buddy Roberts should be out there defending the belt right now.
Well, Terry Taylor is still the champion. If you had a guy on the ring apron, Buddy Roberts might have been the champion.
Well, if the referee would have done his job, I wouldn't have had to go out there.
Terry Taylor, one of the supreme athletes in professional wrestling today, ladies and gentlemen, the current UWF television champion.
It's a clean break by the Libyan.
And he is a big man, Michael. First time we have seen him here on the UWF, a big man. This should be about 275, maybe 280.
Yes, he does. And there he goes. Got the headlock. Taylor shoots him off. Shoulders got moved. Boy, he used 275 pounds of that weight to knock him down, didn't he? You know, this UWF is so hot, Jim Ross. You see everybody coming in from all parts of the world, from all parts of the states. And this Libyan is just one example. Everybody wants that TV title because it's so prestigious. Well, Terry Taylor doesn't deserve it.
Well, that's your opinion, obviously, but he is a phenomenal athlete.
Oh, Taylor here they go.
Test of strength here.
Yes, top wrist lock, both men. I would think that the Libyan would have him here over the weight advantage, but Taylor's hanging tough. Yep, see, there you go. Strength. Now, what all them little girls think about that, huh? What do they think about that pretty little Terry Taylor now when he meets a man?
Well, he's got a lot more positive attributes than just raw power.
Well, it takes more than that to be a pro wrestler, but, beautiful move. Beautiful move, backwards suplex up. The Libyan grabbed a headlock, and Taylor showed right away that he knows a little bit of wrestling. Shoots him into the ropes. Drops him, caught him right on the chin. Right on the chin. The momentum is switched. Snap mare. Like Taylor's setting up for something. Knee drops right to the head. right to the head. He hooked the leg. One, two. Nope, not enough.
Powerful man, the Libyan.
Sure is. Powerful man. He's back up. A lot of guys that needed the head would have took him out. And now the Libyan, a big forearm across the chest. There's another one. I like it. Pounding. Now he's working the gut. See, people are listening to my commentary. The wrestlers are knowing. Work for that air. Take it out of them. They can't breathe. They can't move. They can't move. They can't win. Good turnbuckle. He charged up. Whoa.
Perry Taylor caught the big man coming in. Taylor now firing back with right hands.
Big high back drop. He better keep that big man on the mat. It's a mistake picking him up. Going for a suplex here. I don't know if he's got the strength for it. I doubt it. He did it. Suplexed him.
There's a lot of top challenges for Terry Taylor's championship, ladies and gentlemen. Michael Hayes, one man, the man here
it's
with
a
me.
Reversal. Libyan went leapfrog by Taylor. Oh, there's that forearm. He's going for it. There's that forearm. Two, three. Shot caught
him. He calls it the five off. And Terry Taylor victorious. And still the UWF television champion. He is sensational. There you see him, Terry Taylor.
Now there's a sissy. Yes, me. That's a sissy.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back. The Universal Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship will be on the line when we come back.
It used to be fun to smoke. Not anymore. Now most of your friends have quit, and you would too, if you only knew how.
Now, arrest the smoking habit forever. With Cigarest.
No matter how long you've been smoking, no matter how much you smoke, regardless of how many times you've tried and failed. Now available for the first time, these powerful pills contain a safe and effective formula that acts to arrest nicotine dependence without withdrawal, without frustration, and without gaining a single pound.
Stop smoking and not gain weight?
That's right, not one single pound.
That's like having your cake and eating it too.
Some people call it a miracle because Cigarest does what no amount of willpower can do. It alleviates physical withdrawal symptoms.
I was at a party with a lot of smokers. I had no problem not smoking.
That after dinner cigarette, I didn't want it.
We know you've tried to quit smoking before, probably many times. Now you've given up and stopped trying, haven't you? With Cigarest, you're going to kick the habit forever. And once you've tried our Cigarest program, you'll never want to smoke again.
I would definitely recommend the Cigarest plan.
I would recommend the Cigarest plan.
It's easy and it works.
Our guarantee. You will completely stop smoking in just 5 days, or we'll refund your full purchase price immediately.
If you want to stop smoking, your next cigarette could be your last. All you have to do is pick up the phone and call us now.
With Cigarest, you're guaranteed to stop smoking in just 5 days without withdrawal, without gaining weight. Call toll-free to order 1-800-922-4400. Use your credit card and save COD fees, or send $19.95 to Cigarest. P.O. Box 4444, Carlsbad, California, 92008.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and we're going to see the UWF Heavyweight Championship on the line in just a few moments. But just moments ago, we got some comments from Steve Dr. Death Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy. Let's hear what they had to say right before the matchup.
Boy, this is the big one. This is the big one. This is the one I've been training for, the one I've been running and sweating on that road, the UWF belt. It's just like the Nationals when I went for the number one. I'm coming to the ring, and I'm prepared. I've been running and sweating and building up those muscles. Terry Gordy, you're going to find out how tough I am.
I want everybody out there to take a good look at this title right here. This is the highest paid title in the world. All the major guys all over the world are wanting a shot at this title. Dr. Death, you just happen to be first in line. You're going to get your chance. I don't think anybody from Oklahoma is big enough and good enough to take this title, especially somebody that calls herself Doc. After I get through with you, Doc, you're going to be eliminated.
Well, there it is. Dr. Death, this is the dream match of his lifetime. He's never held a major title, and now he's going for the biggest one.
the Universal Heavyweight title against my brother. And you notice I'm right here beside you, Jim Ross, commentating. I'm not down there in his corner. He won it on his own. He needs nobody to help him defeat Dr. Death.
Well, I hope, Michael, we can take you at your word, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Death, Steve Williams, you heard the comments. He is more than ready to go against Terry Bam Bam Gordy. The match of Dr. Death's lifetime is about to take place here in the Tulsa Convention Center.
From Mormon, Oklahoma, at 270 pounds, Steve Dr. Death Williams.
Dr. Death Steve Williams, what a phenomenal athlete. Remember, it's for the UWF Heavyweight Championship as we get the introductions out of the way. This match, one fall or television time remaining. And this is what, well, I'll tell you. Right here on the UWF, there you see Big Bam Bam Terry Gordy,
there's
Dr. Death Steve Williams.
Belt. And you have to give my brother credit for wrestling for the title right here in Oklahoma, right in Dr. Death's backyard. It could have been in Atlanta. It could have been in our backyard. Whoa! He shoved it back. I think I seen his right hand in Bam Bam's hair.
Well, I don't. You're probably the only person here, Michael. These several thousand did see that.
Yeah, well, they don't look as closely as I do. See, that's why I'm so intelligent. That's why I'm where I'm at, and that's why that's where they're at. There he goes, headlock, shoots him up. Boom! Now who's so big and bad? There you go, Bam Bam, good shoulder smash. That's like two Sherman tanks meeting each other. Up they go, Dr. Death, pick him up. He threw him off. Whoa!
He picked up, he's 295, Terry Bam Bam Gordy, and the good doctor just catapulted, shot put him out across the ring.
Man, that'll jar your lower back, I'll tell you what.
Look at that man. Look at the eyes on that man. Yes, sir, he is ready.
Well, he better be ready because this is his only shot. Once he gets beat, that's it, just like the rest of them. You know, everybody only gets one chance to see the top of that mountain. Then you got to fall down, and after he gets through, he'll see the fall. He's got the headlock here.
Dr. Death Steve Williams never gained the North American title. He has never held a major singles title like the UWF Heavyweight Championship or North American Heavyweight Championship, but he is ready.
Hey, there you go. Now, that was a blatant hair pull. He held onto the hair. Bam Bam went to shoot him off out of the headlock. Here it is again. Same thing. Now, look at that. Referee's doing nothing. I guess that's how the Sooners like to play football, huh? I guess Dr. Death looks at this like when he was in the Orange Bowl, huh?
Sometimes you got to do whatever it takes, Michael. Now, I've been...
Nobody knows that better than me, but that is illegal, and Gilbert's doing nothing about it, and it's still, I think, got to do with his repent for his measly son. There's a good knee, legal knee, right to the gut. Another good one.
He's on the ropes. The referee had to break this situation. Bam, bam, with a clubbing right hand to Dr. Death.
Fires him into the ropes, goes for an elbow. He missed it. Dr. Death with a power. Some strength, that's 295 pounds, but he's holding the truck. See, he's holding the truck. Yep, just like an Oklahomian. Takes a shortcut.
The four-time All-American from the University of Oklahoma, Bam Bam, there you see it. Hard to the canvas.
There's already two reasons I've seen for disqualification. He held onto the hair twice, now picked him up for a slam with the truck. You can't deny it, and nobody out there can.
That's not grounds for disqualification.
It is in my book.
My goodness, well, your book doesn't count. You don't have the striped shirt on. Dr. Death, number 76 for the Sooners, backs Bam Bam Gordy into that corner.
All right, see, Dr. Death isn't breaking. Gilbert's taking his time counting. Good, that's what you get. Whoa! Exchange of price, you go in for a turnbuckle. Gordy reversed it, clothesline. Beautiful. Caught him right up on that chin. Completely legal.
Whether it's the clothesline, the Oriental Spike, which is deadly, I might add,
the Bam
or the
Bam
pile driver, the Bam Bam Slam, he's got it all.
That's why he is the world champion of the universe. Going for a suplex here. That power suplex he learned in Japan. Yeah. And he's got Dr. Death reeling. It could be it. Terry grabbed that leg. Should have grabbed that leg.
Lateral press by Terry Gordy, but Dr. Death in phenomenal condition, as you can easily see.
You've got to hook that leg. Come on, Bam Bam. You know that. That's basic. Good right hand. He's got Dr. Death really. Come on, another one. Boom. Yeah. He's got him now. Come on, Terry, grab the leg. Two, three. See, he's got too much upper body strength. I'm going to have to talk to Terry about that.
It may be too late because this is for the Universal Wrestling Heavyweight Championship.
That's all right. He's
one of the leading
going.
Contenders, Dr. S.D. Williams, is in deep trouble now at the hands of the champion.
Shoots him in, broke the, look at that. Now you want to talk about strength. Shot him in and broke the turnbuckle. Broke the turnbuckle.
Well, that's two studs, baby.
You can expect the unexpected on Universal Wrestling.
He's got a rubber. That should be it. Two. Come on, that was three. That was three.
And it's not like they're doing basketball. If you break a goal, they're just going to keep on going.
This is wrestling, baby. No pads, no nothing. Hard-earned sheer guts. See, the ring crew's out there trying to fix it. By the time this match gets over, they may have the whole ring torn down.
He's a walking weapon, the UWF champion, and Dr. Death has got to mount some type of attack here. Dr. Death with a headbutt of his own.
To the gut there, but it looked a little low to me. Here goes Terry, another suplex to finish him. Dr. Death blocked it. Reversed it. Come on, Terry, get up. Come on, baby, get up. Come on. He's got more in him than Dr. Death.
Well, that's debatable. Dr. Death buries a right hand deep into the midsection.
Illegal. Totally illegal. There's a right hand. Another illegal. Illegal. Come on. Come on, Batman. Come on, man. Another right hand. Come on. Stop that. He should be disqualified. What? Snapmare. What's he going for? Went to the well one too many times.
Doc went to the headbutt. Bam Bam very alertly moved out of the way, and now looking back over on the attack is Gordy.
Beautiful. Good to hit.
There's that crowd solidly behind Dr. S.D. Williams.
Terry backs him up in the turnbuckle. Goes for it. He reversed it. Dr. Death went full. He went for a spear. Yeah. Try that against the Georgia Bulldogs. See what happens, huh? Now, there you go. That's why he's the Universal Champion. He's hurt that neck, and he knows to stay on it. Stay where the animal's wounded. Run him back there again, Terry. Yeah.
Well, Dr. Death's got to have a 20-inch neck.
Yeah, but I don't care if it's a 30-inch neck. When you got Bam Bam bamming on you. And the momentum when he went for that spear. Oh, he's sitting up for the pile driver. This is it. I know it's going to be it. He's got him. Wait a minute. Hey! Hey!
Ladies and gentlemen,
wait, that's
it was not intentional. It was not intentional.
Care.
And
I don't care. No, I'm going down there.
You said you were going to stay here. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. We'll be right back at this timeout.
I'd like to take this time to say hello to all the Universal Wrestling Federation fans and tell you I appreciate your support. Everybody saw what happened today on TV. I went against that Libyan, who's a big, tough man, and defended this title. And that's the way I want to be. Any chance I get to defend this on television to prove to the people and to the opponents on here that I am a worthy champion. Now, Dr. Death is in there against Terry Gordon. I don't want to be out here too long. This is going to be a great match. I'm just saying right now that the winner of this match, it could be Dr. Death, and it could be Terry Gordy. But I came here with one thing in mind, and that was to be the competition, not just a competitor. And I'm saying now that I'd like to challenge the winner of the match, and if it is Dr. Death, that'd be great, and if it's Terry Gordy, that'd be good too. Now, it's either one, it could come out either way. Now, the people out there have been watching Universal Wrestling Federation grow into the fastest and the largest wrestling organization in the country today. It's the fastest growing. More people watch us, and I think you can see why. Because the competition is number one. You have matches on TV that are main events anywhere in the country. Now, that's good for y'all, but it's also a little tough on us, because when you look at my head, you can see I've got stitches in my head, and at the wear and tear of being the champion, it's starting to tell on me just a little bit. But every night, everybody's geared up, and they're ready, and it means good competition for the fans. It also means a hard night's work for us. So if you just keep giving us your support, we'll be giving you 110%, because the Universal Wrestling Federation is where it's at. I don't want to keep you too much longer. We're going to go back to the match in the ring, and I just want to say that I'm challenging the winner of this match, whether it's Dr. Death or Terry Gordy.
Yes, that's right. Stay tuned, everybody. There's about to be a big explosion coming up, and it's finally the one Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert has been waiting for. Ever since I've been in Universal Wrestling Federation, ever since I've had to look at that ugly face of Cowboy Bill Watts and listen to him talk about me like a dirty dog. Well, what you may think, and all these rest of these people out here watching me now may think, that when I laid that Russian flag over you, and when I hit you with that red, good-looking shovel of mine, maybe that was it. Maybe that's all it took from me. Maybe that's all I wanted to do. But it's not. I've still got a little bit more. And then I showed everybody the great picture I had, the one where you were laying with the Russian flag over you. But still, now, watch. What I want is a little bit more. You see, what I want is when my man defeats you today and beats you, that means I get to take this long belt of yours. And you get to bend over and grab those ankles, boy. And I'm also going to make you take that shirt off of yours, because I want you to be able to remember it every time you look in the mirror. Then I'm going to stand back. I'm going to warm up, boy. And then I'm going to I am going to lash you like the yellow dog that you are. Now, for some incident, some little coincidence, if you were to beat my man, that's right, you get 5 minutes alone with me, Bill Watts, but I want to tell you now, if you get that lucky, if you ever get that chance, you better take it and you better do it good, because it may be the last time that you ever touch me, because I am the master. I am the master of having the greatest plans in wrestling, so you better be ready.
After this, time out. In just a matter of weeks, the newly opened Chris Koch Hyundai in Turnersville, New Jersey, has become one of the largest volume Hyundai dealers in the nation. Apparently, one of the reasons for this success, you don't have to wait for your Hyundai at Chris Koch.
We have the car, your color, your equipment that you want here today and ready to go.
You haven't marked up prices on these cars, Chris.
Not at all. The discount is already in there. We're not marking them up. We're using the factory's already discounted prices. We're interested in volume and not in profits.
We asked Chris how customers react to the new Hyundai.
They can't believe it. They absolutely are flabbergasted at the quality of the car and the amount of standard equipment that they get with a car. They just can't believe it.
Hyundai sell for under $5,000. We asked Chris how much a well-equipped Hyundai would cost.
Under $8,000. As a matter of fact, the only way you can spend $10,000 here is to buy two of them.
And ask Chris who's buying Hyundai?
Smart people. Those are the people that are buying this car.
The new Chris Koch Hyundai, Route 42, Black Horse Pike, Turnersville, New Jersey.
Hello, I'm Martin Sheen here in Cambridge, England. Please join me, Hal Linden, John Denver, and many others for Lady Liberty, a musical salute to America.
Here's the latest AccuWeather forecast from 65 WSJT.
Afternoon shows a band of moisture extending from the remains of Bonnie over Arkansas up across Ohio and into the northeastern states. In this warm, humid flow of air, heavy thunderstorms developed this afternoon in northwestern Virginia and moved across that state to southern Maryland and Delaware. But it should remain dry locally tonight, with temperatures dropping only to the uncomfortable 70s. Cold front currently in the western Great Lakes will by tomorrow evening be approaching our area. Ahead of this front, we'll have a very warm, humid day with some sunshine and perhaps a thunderstorm late in the afternoon or evening. A refreshing air mass from central Canada will take over early in the week to give us sunshine and pleasant conditions Monday and Tuesday. For AccuWeather, this is meteorologist Dave Bowers.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We'll try to put this situation in a little bit of perspective, what has just transpired. Both Steve Dr. Death Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy were disqualified as the result of the match. But I think perhaps a couple of things very important here. Referee Tommy Gilbert was carried from the ring area. We will check on that situation and keep you abreast of the situation. Michael Hayes cannot keep his nose out of other people's business. He said he was going to sit here. He did not do that. Be that as it may, ladies and gentlemen, earlier in the week, I had the opportunity to talk with Hacksaw Jim Duggan about some events, some very important events in his career that have come to pass in the last few weeks involving General Skandar Akbar, specifically Kamala and the one-man gang, also the big situation in Houston, Texas. Now let's go to that feature. I had some comments with Hacksaw Duggan. Let's hear what he had to say and see him in action. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you've seen what has happened in Houston, Texas in the big UWF tournament. Hacksaw Jim Duggan's unfortunate confrontation, as it is, with the one-man gang. A lot of people, and me too, very concerned about your health. 27 stitches and
a concussion. A lot of people were surprised also, Jim Ross, because the one-man gang wasn't supposed to be there. He picked his shot and came on in and got his stuff in. Uninvited, I may say. But yeah, you're right. I took a pretty good blow. I had my head split open big enough you could stick your hand right in the hole. But big one-man gang wasn't surprised to see Hacksaw Jim Duggan pop up and come back out. His eyes got that big, Jim Ross.
A lot of people also are not only wanting to see that, but the situation involving you and Terry Gordy recently on the UWF. Let's go now back in time and look at that piece of tape during the closing moments of when they looked eye to eye.
Turn into... because of these people is a stupid suck. Oh, it's breaking down. Big Hacksaw Duggan has leveled Michael Hayes. Hacksaw Duggan, boy, this was falling. And Duggan, they just want to get it on. These two big stallions, Duggan and Bam Bam.
Saw that there, Jim Ross? You saw what happened? Oh, Hacksaw Jim Duggan gets a little excited. The doctors say, Hacksaw, don't go nowhere near the ring. Well, I wanted to go out there, and I wanted to move that young Jeff Gaylord aside, and I wanted to tell Terry Gordy, eye to eye, man to man, that you don't deserve that belt. You didn't beat a 100% Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and I'm going to take it away from you, tough guy.
Well, thank goodness you're 100% now, yeah. No doubt about that. And
But when you were injured, you were scheduled to go against Kamala in the Universal Wrestling Federation. The doctors wouldn't give you clearance. Steve Williams took your place, and then it really got exciting.
My buddy Steve Williams, I tell you, we just didn't fall off no potato wagon. We had our suspicions that Skandar Akbar had something up his sleeve, so we had a little reserve plan. We had the Dulce Lumber Company.
Let's go now back in time and see that tape.
I was hurt bad. I was hurt real bad, Jim Ross. 2 weeks I laid in bed with hot rags, scalding hot rags in my head, trying to take this swelling down. 2 weeks, the only thing that went through my mind was one man gang, Akbar. Old Skandar Akbar, the man that burned me. You're not happy with me, Akbar. You're still coming after to get me, Jim Ross. But I'm 100% now. I took the 2 weeks off. I did what the doctor said. Plenty of rest, lots of fluid, and keep something on your mind. Keep your mind active. And I kept my mind active, Jim Ross. One man gang, you're the man that did this. Akbar, you're the man leading. And Terry Gordy, UWF heavyweight champion, I haven't forgotten you either. Tough guy.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with more Universal Wrestling Federation action after this timeout.
Uh-oh. If you rip this expensive car seat, you have to mend it with ugly vinyl tape. But wait, your vinyl mender kit will make rips and tears look as good as new and stronger than ever. Vinyl Mender, the remarkable patented repair process used by the three major car manufacturers to mend rips on the assembly line. Watch this. Vinyl Mender makes repairs quickly and easily on vinyl and naugahyde in your home, office, boat, or restaurant. Repair expensive furniture, golf bags, leather coats, vinyl car roofs, luggage, and much more. The Vinyl Mender Kit is easy to use and will save you hundreds of dollars in costly repairs. Apply Vinyl Mender, then blend the grain textured pattern, match the color, and it's just like new. Vinyl Mender is unconditionally guaranteed. For unusual repair problems, call the toll-free hotline number listed in the enclosed instruction manual. The Vinyl Mender Kit. Just $19.95 with an absolute money-back guarantee is not available in stores. Order now and receive Fabric Mender as a free bonus. Fabric Mender will repair your cloth and fabric furniture just as quickly and easily. Call now for rush delivery of the Vinyl Mender Kit and your free gift.
Use your credit card for rush delivery and call toll-free 1-800-441-4848 or mail check or money order for $19.95 plus $3 shipping and handling to P.O. Box 2182, Dallas, Texas. Unconditional money-back guarantee. Call 1-800-441-4848. Operators are standing by for your order.
This is the Survivor, the ultimate knife with all the accessories to help you survive on your own. Each survival knife is a whopping 12 inches long, yes, a foot in length, yet so perfectly balanced, it cuts like an extension of your own hand. From the razor-sharp tip of the blade to the top of the handle, the entire blade is made of 420 molecular stainless steel. And at the bottom of the handle is a precision liquid compass. You'll know where you are and where you're going. Yet now you can get one during this limited publicity campaign for the special TV price of $10. But wait, there's more. You'll also get the companion survival kit, cleverly concealed in the handle of the survival knife. You get emergency fishing equipment, emergency sewing repair kit, emergency cable saw, and emergency waterproof wrap matches. Yet if you order now, you'll get it all for only $10. And here's another incredible surprise. You'll get this heavy-duty sheath. It comes with a built-in snap pouch containing a sharpening stone. And you can keep the sheath and sharpening stone free, even if you decide to return the survival knife for a complete refund. Be a survivor. Buy the Survivor. So order your choice of black or camouflage.
And if you order within 1 hour, you'll also get this multi-purpose sportsman's knife.
To get your survival knife plus companion survival kit plus your free sportsman's knife, just call toll-free 1-800-453-9000. That's 1-800-453-9000. Save $5 COD and handling charge by using your credit card. Or mail $10 to Survival Knife, Box C622, Brooklyn, New York, 11219.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from...
This is my time, and I have something very important to say. And I want everyone here, and I want everyone at home And everybody here's legend has done the Hot Stuff International this past week in Jackson, Mississippi. Mr. Cowboy Bill Watts took it upon himself to come into the ring with a baseball bat. And he used the baseball bat on my Russian Korchenko. I ran for... And Korchenko is not here any longer.
Those comments, ladies and gentlemen, from Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. And Cowboy Bill Watts. The cowboy is back, no doubt about that, and he's on his way to the ring, ready for war. And he has this cowboy belt with him. And I know the fans watching at home, and certainly this tremendous crowd here at the Tulsa Convention Center, hope that that belt does not come into play. They want to see the cowboy get 5 minutes with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert.
Introducing from Bixby, Oklahoma, at 300 pounds, Cowboy Bill Watts. Ladies and gentlemen, Watts wins. He gets 5 minutes with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. If Sting wins, Gilbert will give Watts 5 lashes with Cowboy's own belt. This match, one fall or television time remaining.
I want to say one thing, Hot Stuff. In Jackson, Mississippi, when that big fat Russian hightailed it after he looked in the eyes of a warrior, it's the beginning of the end of Hot Stuff International. Tonight's the last night. And I'll tell you what, I'm going to take this punk out, and then I'm going to do what I promised your daddy and all these people I do. I'm going to whip your tail.
Look at that, ladies and gentlemen. That man has been to war and survived. He has been to battle with the biggest names in professional wrestling, and he is still one big, mean cowboy. Don't ever doubt it one bit. Sting, the young lion, the only man left in Hot Stuff International. Cowboy Bill Watts with that tackle. He also played football for the University of Oklahoma. Dr. S.D. Williams has picked up a lot of tricks from the big cowboy. Remember, stipulations in this television match. Can you believe it? Right here on television, on the UWF, and nowhere else but the UWF, you're going to see something like this, ladies and gentlemen. Collar and elbow tie-up. Watts backing Sting into those ropes now. And the young man with a phenomenal physique is in dire straits, and the cowboy... Sting tied up in those ropes. Watts a slap right to the face. That's 300 pounds, and Eddie Gilbert's trying to get his man. And Watts with a short ride, and Gilbert is down. Down and to the floor. Watts now controlling Sting. All the way out, back in, Sting. Watts has got some, he really threw that young man with some velocity into that center turnbuckle, and the cowboy has got him up, and that means that it's a stampede. Gilbert was on the top rope, but Watts has got the pinfall. The cowboy.
Hold the hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert. Sting is out of it. Watch with that hemlock right hand, right to the head. And now he's just ripping the clothes. Gilbert's fashion wear is being depleted, and Watts has busted his head. He's busted the gourd of hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert, and Gilbert is limp-legged. Watts promised the people what he was going to do, and now he's got the belt, and that's leather to skin. The cowboy is whipping hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert, and I mean he is whipping him bad. Well, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen, here come the Freebirds. Watts has got the belt, and all three Freebirds in the ring with the cowboy. And now Sting's back in the ring. They got a ring full against the cowboy. The Freebirds have come to the ring. And boy, we've got a tense situation at ringside. The Freebirds and Sting. They're holding the cowboy. There goes the referee, and Gordy is on the top rope with that Oriental spike and down to the neck of the cowboy. We mentioned it before. Gordy is the master of the Oriental spike, and the Freebirds are kicking away at Cowboy Bill Watts. Michael Hayes, they've been so insulted and embarrassed and humiliated and punished. And look at Gilbert, the cowboy worked him over. And now Gilbert's holding Watts down. It was Gilbert that laid the flag on Cowboy Bill Watts. There goes... They're trying to get some order restored. There's Tim Mantell, ladies and gentlemen. Tim Mantell in the ring to try to get this thing put back together. And Cowboy Bill Watts, they've hammered him with everything they've got. And Gordy's got that Oriental spike on the cowboy. Bam, bam, Gordy's got that spike, and he's trying to get into the throat of Cowboy Bill Watts. The Oriental spike, one of the most deadly maneuvers in wrestling. And bam, bam, all 295 pounds, the Freebirds punished and hammered Cowboy Bill Watts in that spike. They've got to be careful. And the great dressing rooms are being emptied. Here comes Tommo Guerrero, Hacksaw Duggan, and Dr. Death are coming out. But how Gordy's had that spike on all this time, and we've got war breaking loose all over the ring here in the UWF. Cowboy Bill Watts is down. Duggan is kicking away, and bam, bam, Gordy. Taylor, but Watts has had the Oriental spike on him for so long, and Watts is laying motionless. The Freebirds came to the ring with Gilbert. We're going to keep it right here. Watts, they had the Oriental spike on him for a long, long time, and he has not moved in the last several moments. This crowd here is hushed. Cowboy Bill Watts has been, I mean, brutalized by the Freebirds. I've never seen anybody with the Oriental, I've never seen Gordy with the Oriental spike on anybody like he had it on Watts for such a long period of time. The people are standing and it's hushed. Watts bleeding from the mouth. He's bleeding internally. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got to get out. We'll be back. We'll be back.
Find your way to Freedom Ford.
Utech, Pennsauken, New Jersey, in the Cherry Hill area.
It's Evil Horrible Monster and Other Nasty Characters Week on the 65 Goldmine Movie. Monday, Godzilla protects Tokyo in Godzilla vs. the Cosmic Monster. Tuesday, Howard Vernon is Orloff against the Invisible Man. Wednesday, Ralph Bates and Martine Beswick are Dr. Jekyll and Sister Hyde. Thursday, John Ireland and John Carradine are living in the House of Seven Corpses. And Friday, the original uncut cult classic, Night of the Living Dead, all next week on 65 WSJT.
Thanks very much for staying with us, everybody. I've asked Frank Ducey to come out and join us. Frank, you were in the dressing room just a few moments ago. What did you see?
Well, I'll tell you, I saw Cowboy Bill Watts down and down bad. He's bleeding from the throat. You know, the Asiatic spike is a move that should be outlawed in most of the civilized world. He's bleeding from the throat. He's down. He's barely conscious. They're working on him right now. I'm not sure at this point. We're just going to have to wait and see. The Cowboy's tough. He's He's been hurt before, and he's been hurt bad before. If there's a way that any human being can come back, he will. But only time is going to tell.
Thanks a lot, Frank. Please stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. We've got the Birdman coming up in just a few moments. Now let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from Havana, Cuba, at 238 pounds, Gustavo Mendoza.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Gustavo Mendoza has been the object of a lot of attention in the Universal Wrestling Federation because on our open, the fans got a look at that drop kick. The last time that these two men met on television, Coco Ware planted that Cuban. And Mendoza has wanted a rematch since that time. He's going to get it here on television. And you hear Morris Day in the background, and they'll be jiving in the aisles momentarily when the Birdman comes to the ring. Now, they don't play music like this on 74 KRMG. They're broadcasting this event live, ladies and gentlemen, throughout the state of Oklahoma, live radio. Wrestling is on fire in the Universal Wrestling Federation. That young man from Union City, Tennessee, is one of the reasons why.
You're right, Jim. Wrestling is definitely the hottest ticket in town today. I'll tell you another thing, too. If Coco Beware plants another drop kick on Gustavo Mendoza, the result's going to be the exact same as it was last time. He's going to plant him 1, 2, 3. So Mendoza better have been working on a defense for that Birdman's drop kick.
Well, Mendoza really clamored for rematch. Matchmaker Grizzly Smith went to the Birdman. He's always ready. He'll be ready in Memphis, Tennessee on July the 25th as well. I want to salute my friends down in my hometown, Westville, Oklahoma. We had one of the most successful benefit events down there recently that we've ever had. 2,700 people in attendance in a town of a 1,000 population. My hats are off to the hard-working group of the Little League.
That shows you what an organization can do.
Birdman getting down there.
The ring at 230 pounds from Motown City, the Birdman, Coco Beware. This match, one fall or television time remaining.
Jim, I know I've said it before, but I have to say it again and again. Every week on the Universal Wrestling Federation, the excitement grows and grows. Bill Watts in the back, attacked by the Freebirds. I don't know if it was a plot.
And now Mendoza is attacking the Birdman. He said he won the rematch. I don't mean to cut you off, Frank. Excuse me for that. But ladies and gentlemen, Mendoza won the rematch. And the Birdman is not even, he hasn't even got out of his ring jacket, obviously, as Mendoza humiliated with that thunderous dropkick from the Birdman the last time they met on television. And Mendoza has taken liberties with Coco Beware.
I guess he's found the cure to the dropkick. That's not to let the Birdman get off his feet, not to let him get off the mat. Mendoza's all over him.
Birdman ducked one maneuver, but Mendoza with the clothesline, unorthodox maneuver there. I don't know what you call that.
I'm not sure. You know, south of the border, you see a lot of those unorthodox moves. That was definitely one. That's what makes this Mendoza such a dangerous wrestler. He mixes the American catch-as-catch-can style with south of the border aerobatic style. He's a unique person.
Backbreaker by Mendoza. Coco Ware has not got out of the starting blocks as of yet in this UWF contest, ladies and gentlemen.
It's been all Mendoza.
What a phenomenal hour with the Birdman now. He's smoking and he's poking. And that right hand right to the face of Mendoza, and he is reeling into the corner. Ooh! Woo-hoo! What a clothesline!
Gee,
boy, they could feel that one back in Union City. The little nose guard, and he tore his head off there.
I'll tell you what, that's a fullback's nightmare right there.
Coco Ware is lightning quick, and there's a drop kick. UWF.
Here it is, Jim. Here it is.
Boom! Right on the chin!
You can call this all in the dogs.
Oh, it's
over.
You can count to 3 or 33 in the winner. The Birdman is, he is diving.
Coco Beware.
Coco Beware. And the crowd loves that young man, and we'll be back with the missing link and Jack Victor after this timeout.
The following message is going to come as a big surprise to you. Just take a look at this ring. It's the famous double rope band ring. This lovely ring is handset with a brilliant cluster of 30 genuine diamels. And the ring is layered entirely in genuine 14-karat gold. Yes, the double rope band ring you're looking at is the best-selling and most expensive ring ever sold by one of America's most famous jewelry catalogs. Yet now, it's available from us exclusively through this TV offer for only $12.95. But wait, there's more. If you order promptly, you'll also get this beautiful triple-tier dinner ring at no extra cost. It's hand-set with 9 ruby-red faceted crystals, plus 17 genuine diamels. Yes, you get both the triple-tier dinner ring and the double rope band ring for the unheard-of price of $12.95. And here's another incredible surprise. If you order within 24 hours, you'll also get this Scandinavian snowball ring free of charge. It's set with a pair of exquisite faux pearls and matched with sparkling diamels.
Things are just getting a little bit out of hand here, a little hot and heavy. The Freebirds come out here and what they did to Bill Watts is entirely wrong, but they didn't finish the job. Now, I don't know, what makes you look at this a little bit differently is any time it could be one of us.
Could be one of us, you know, that's why I come out here today. Because you just can't sit back with your feet up in the air, sipping on a soda pop, watching the way things are going on in the UWF. What just happened to Bill Watts, what happened to me in Houston, Texas, when they split old Hacksaw Duggan's skull like a ripe tomato. But old Hack didn't stay down, old Terry don't stay down, and I guarantee you, that big cowboy out there, he's not going to stay down, because this is the UWF. This is the home of winners. So let me tell you Freebird something. You're not in Atlanta, Georgia, you're not in Miami, Florida, and you're not up north somewhere. You're right here. You're at Terry Taylor's home. You're at Hacksaw Jim Duggan's home. You're in Dr. Death, Ted DiBiase, and the big cowboy. You don't come down here roughshod. Tough guys.
Introducing at 252 pounds from Atlantic City, New Jersey, Jack Victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, we just have some comments from Cowboy Bill Watts in the dressing room. Let's go to the dressing room at this time.
I've always stood for what I've believed in. It may not sometimes be the most popular, and it may not be easy, but I've always believed that you got to stand for what you say, and you got to try to back it up. When I got involved with hot stuff and threw my hat back in the ring, I knew I'd be live bait. And Freebirds, I know I've stuck in your craw a long time, because this is where you first gained your fame, when you blinded the junkyard dog. And he was out for 9 long weeks. And I kicked your tail then, and I forced you to leave, and I embarrassed you. And now you've run rampant. You've just run roughshod over the whole world, and you've built your reputation, and you've built your courage. And you've come back, and you've jumped me. But you made one fatal mistake. I'm still breathing.
Coming a heated feud, and look at the leak. His hand is a weapon, and Victory is hammered.
That was definitely the wrong way to assault the missing link. You don't work with that head.
Jack Victory tried to get that quick advantage on the missing link. And now the link, communicating somewhat with Dark Journey, but Victory seizing that moment now, taking over on the missing link. The missing link, and where is Lady Maxine? After what happened in the Superdome, Maxine she's had for higher ground, let's say. I haven't seen her.
Maybe she was driving Korchenko's getaway car.
I'll tell you, after the Superdome and what she got from Dark Journey, she's nowhere to be found, and Victory now trying to take over and is doing so on the missing link.
You've got to give Jack Victory credit. You know, it takes a certain amount of intestinal fortitude just to get into it. Look at him. He's after Dark Journey.
Look at Victory. He knows that she ran that Maxine out of the area. And Victory back in trying to get Dark Journey. The missing link beats him with a headbutt. The missing link has met Jack Victory with a headbutt. And it's like a battering ram. And Dark Journey slaps an insult to injury.
That was his mistake right there. He might have beat the missing link, but you can't beat him if you're going after Dark Journey. That's where he made his mistake. Dark Journey is the inspiration for the missing link, Jim.
Jack Victory, ladies and gentlemen, the missing link is awesome. And Dark Journey, what a pair they are. Next week, it'll be Hacksaw Duggan and Terry Taylor versus Terry Bam Bam Gordy and Buddy Roberts. You'll see the Fantastics here next week. Chavo Guerrero.